you today. Today we're out here doing something different, something crazy, something I really haven't done before. Totally different type of video. Today is September the 20th. It's 20 to 5 p.m. And I got home about 3 o'clock and the weather, all the weather channels are flashing and blipping and doing all their thing. Because apparently there's a line of thunder cells that are coming our way. So we are under severe thunderstorm warnings. We're under tornado watch. And I thought, well, you know, it's a Friday night, so why hang out with my buddies watching my Tiger Cats beat up the Edmonton Eskimos when I can come out here and do this? So I came, I don't know, I'm a few kilometers from house. I jumped on my bike. I quick threw together a pack, some water, my stove, just a little grub to eat, some coffee, a tarp, and you guys, man. So, who knows? I'm not one of those people that judge the weather people. They never know what they're talking about. I'm not one of those guys. How can you? This system moves this way. This wind is blowing that way. There's a cold front, a high pressure. I mean, who knows, man? Mother Nature could just turn around and say, I'm going to go home now. You never know. So, but anyways, I'll give you a quick little look around here, and then I'm going to go ahead and get a tarp set up here, and just in case the rain comes, I can get under and I can sit comfortably and maybe wait for a light show, or even more. So, I don't know, but they're forecasting for dinner time. Like I said here, it's 20 to 5 Central Time. And so I would imagine dinner time is coming anytime like right now, so I should get my stuff together. But I'll give you a quick pan around so that you can, I put myself up here on a bit of a knob, my bug out bag, which is waterproof, my bike. I got a few trees here. Now I know a lightning storm and stuff like that, I am kind of in the open, but there's lots of trees all the way around us. I know that you're on a bit of an angle there, so please forgive me. But one thing I have going for me is I don't have any lights. I don't have any street lights over here. I don't know what the rules and regulations are for me being in this park right now, or for the night, or what time I'm supposed to be vacated, or whatever. But if the storm comes like they're predicting the storm is going to come, I don't think anybody's going to worry about it, about me being down in here after, say, 10 or 11 o'clock at night. Whatever park rules are for municipalities, I don't have any clue. So, but that being said, I'm going to go ahead and start stringing up some tarp and get a little shelter going for myself. The problem is the wind's going to be blowing in. The wind is blowing towards my face right now. Which means the rain will be coming towards my face right now, but that's the area that I want to shoot. So, let's see if we can't come up with something that I can kind of half-ass stay sheltered, but still want to be able to film out of. So, I'm going to go ahead and get working on that now. I'll tune you back in a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay. Took a little longer than usual, but whatever. It's up. Anyways, what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to put out some more guy lines. We're really going to suck this sucker down to the ground. This way I can get in there. I can get in behind out of some rain. There's lots of headroom in there for me. Lots of room for my gear and whatever. Prusik on each end just to hold it out taut. And I got the center pole up there, which I can raise or lower as I need, just for the filming. So we'll see. You know, I'm standing here talking to you guys, and it's like now all of a sudden the clouds are taking off. I don't know what's gonna go on here, but like the sun's poking through over here. So I'm not exactly sure what's going on, but I'm getting ready to hunker down here, and we'll catch up with you in a little bit. Sitting in my little quick shelter I threw up. This is my Rab Steel Tarp 2. And I got I'll take a look at that in a little bit. But a lot of people always ask, well, you know, or they always wonder, what does it take to get that photograph? What does it take to get that shot? What does it take to get that explosive view? Well, I'll tell you what it takes. It takes some setup, and it takes a whole bunch of patience. So today our goal is the Weather Channel and all the other weather things that I could research. We're all calling for huge storms coming through. A line of thunderstorms is coming across across southern Manitoba. Are expected to hit Winnipeg, where I am right now. Anywhere between dinner time and a little later. So here I am. I quick threw together my bug out bag and basically just came running out down here about 5 kilometers away from home and set things up. So I thought while we were in here, just before we take a look at the shelter, I'll just give you a little look-see of what at the provisions that I brought for myself today. So starting off, we're starting off here with the dry case. Get your tech wet. It's it's meant for kayaking, canoeing. This bag is old, but it's still waterproof, 100% waterproof. I love that about this bag. And it's just called dry case. Get your tech wet. In the outside pocket, I have my North Face rain jacket. I'm wearing my rain pants as we speak. I got a red ant on me. Okay, inside, because they're expecting to bring low pressure, a really cold front is going to be moving through. Right now it's like 21 degrees, but that wind is picking up as we speak, and it's bringing a low pressure and a cold front with it. So I have my North Face wind wall vest and a heavy zip-up hoodie. We also have some grub. We have a coffee supplies, we got the coffee mug, and we got the cooking set, the kitchen. On top of that, we've got our drinking water, more drinking water, and this dry case is the Brooks bag. It's a wet bag. We have camera gear, we have headlamp, we have battery pack, and cords and cables, etc. We have a tarp to sit on, that's basically about it for that. Now, we'll take you a look on the outside here. Okay, so basically what we've done is we've run a line across from one tree to another. We put our center tab of the tarp in through there. We have a Prusik knot on either end. And then we just went around basically and we just hauled her down to the ground, and I want an opening for being able to have my camera where I can pretty much keep it out of the weather, but I can take a look at the sky and whatever's going on. Now, if you take a look at the sky, it doesn't look like there's any much of a storm moving in, but as we see, the clouds are rolling and they're moving pretty quick. It doesn't take much to change that. So as you can see, these dark clouds just above the trees here, we don't know. That's the whole thing, guys. All you can do basically is basically, all you can do is go by the information that you've been given, the information that you've researched, and then chase after it and see what you can come up with. And that's basically all that we can do on this point. Almost exactly 6 o'clock on the note. I sitting here reading my book, just waiting to see what the weather's gonna do, and she looks like she's getting pretty bright. Let's have a little look-see here. I seem to have a nosy Parker that's just kind of hanging around behind me. Apparently not liking what I'm up to here today, but that's for them to deal with and not for me to worry about, because I don't care about those kind of people. But she's looks like she's lighting it up here. We're not too sure, but we're gonna hang out here a little while longer and see what becomes of it. Alright guys, just keeping you updated. Okay, well, as you can see now, it's still just a little after 6, about 6 after 6, and the clouds have all but pretty much moved out, so, at least the dark ones anyways. Like I say, you can never tell with weather. Chances are I came down here for nothing. Never know. But this is what it takes, guys, you know, like I was saying earlier about what does it take to get that picture, what does it take to get that shot, it takes your research. You know, I did my research, I resourced a few sources of information about the weather today. They all said the exact same thing, and I came out, and now it's just a waiting game. So I guess basically that's what we're gonna do, is we're just gonna sit, we're gonna wait, and see what goes on. But you never know, that storm could still be rolling in, or maybe it's just it's just not gonna happen. So take another look at that sky, and I don't know, maybe we'll be heading her home, maybe we won't, I'm not quite sure. Okay guys, well it's another hour later, it's 7 o'clock now, just hair under, and the wind had picked up, huge. And blew out all the skies, as we seen that. And then the wind kind of died down. The wind is pretty calm right now, to be honest with you. But so take a look here. We are certainly looking a little different from what we just were. That's for sure. So, which is nice. But like I say, this is... it's a waiting game. You never know what's going to happen. You never know what Mother Nature's up to. And in order to capture Mother Nature, like I'm trying to do today, it's just putting in the time. You know, you got to put in that time. Sit and you wait. And this is part of what it takes to capture this on film, and we're still not sure if anything's going to become of it, but we certainly are hopeful. We got just a little splattering of rain. You can probably see a couple of raindrops on the lens. I'm hoping that this camera works because I had broke it or damaged it, I guess I should say, on my trip to the Whiteshell. So we're not exactly quite sure. We know that it's no longer waterproof, I can tell you that much. We're hoping for the best here because I should be able to have this camera out in a little bit of rain, so I can capture the lightning and whatnot. Anyways, I just wanted to give a little update, and the sky is very strange. It's very awesome though, because just a second ago it was very dark over the city, and now it's lightening up, and it's darkening up over here. As you can see, I have the camera shelter. Is set up to capture the images behind, because I don't want the light from the city. I don't want all this light from the city over here. What I'm looking for is where there's no lights. It's just trees, it's just dark this way, and I'm hoping that we can get some good thunder strikes and we can get a good show going this way, guys. So with that being said, I'm gonna get you back. You're gonna keep some charge in the battery. I have another battery with me, but I want to keep this one charged as much as possible. Just taking a look at these white clouds over here. Sorry, I'll get out of the way. Take a look at these white clouds over here. They're just starting to move over the tops of the trees there. Basically what I'm just doing, guys, I'm just looking for something to happen. Oh, there we go. There we go. That's what we're looking for. That was right across the sky. I don't know if I got it or not. Sorry about the train. But this is exactly what it takes, guys, to come out, try to get these shots. Now here's something for you. Let's have a look right behind me. Isn't that crazy? Look at that sky there. And then we come back over. Raindrops are just starting to fall. And see where that flash came from. But it looks like it's on its way. As you can hear, the rain's falling. We're in my little shelter. We're staying protected. Wind is starting to buffet around a little bit, which is nice. And which kind of means that there's going to be a storm. And I don't know. So right now we're just going to just make sure that all the gear's put properly. We're, you know, because you don't want to be misplacing gear when you're out here and doing all that kind of fun stuff. So I'm just going to go through my gear, make sure I know where everything is, make sure everything's packed. And we're just going to wait and see if anything comes out of this show. So we're hopeful because we're out here putting the time in. But like I say, it's who knows, you know? This could just blow over in another 5 minutes and be done with, or it could turn into a real banger. Well, okay guys, we're home. It's just absolutely pouring. I'm absolutely soaking wet to the bone. And that's the way it goes when you're trying to film the thunderstorms. But certainly didn't work out in our favor in regards to what the weatherman had predicted. And so goes the battle. But it is when it comes to rainfall precipitation. We're supposed to get like 50 millimeters tonight or something. And that's a lot, up to 100. So anyways, I'm home now, and I'm gonna go and get unwet and take a look at some of this footage. But just so you know, that's exactly how things go when you go and, you know, you want to photograph that sun or that, in this case, the lightning. That's just the way things go, guys. So sometimes it works out in your favor, sometimes you get that shot, and sometimes you don't. So at least with my bonus of wanting to be outside as much as possible, that's exactly what happened there. So I got to spend time outside. Rain or not, I love it anyways. So anyways, guys, thanks a lot for coming along for the ride. And we'll talk to you next one.